The update to LG's curved smartphone just might be one of the most exciting things coming out of CES 2015. Hey, it's Joshua Vigar from Android Authority. What's going on, everybody? And this is the LG G Flex 2. The biggest story out of design happens to be its size, as the G Flex originally was just too big for a lot of users out there, so LG brought it down by about half an inch, making this a 5.5 inch screen, but overall makes this a very comfortable phone in the hand. 5.5 inches is just outside the level of comfort, or just within it rather, and with this curve on there, the ergonomics on this phone are basically off the charts. The backing is removable, but the battery underneath is embedded. Speaking of the back though, we still have that signature LG button layout with the power and volume rockers that are easily accessed by an index finger. Moving over to the front though, we do see that the elements of the screen do curve quite nicely on the display, making for a somewhat more immersive experience, but in my opinion, the curve mostly helps with the ergonomics, especially when you consider the smaller size of this device. Speaking of the screen, we do have a now LG in-house created panel here that is 20% more durable than Corning Gorilla Glass 3, and it is called DuraGuard Glass. The G Flex 2 also gets a bump up to 1080p resolution, and as such, this P-OLED display now brings 403 pixels per inch. The end result is a very solid viewing experience with vivid colors and excellent angles, and while this isn't quite as stunning as, let's say, quad HD powered flagships like the G3 in the same family, you still can't go wrong with full HD. It was absolutely clear that LG really wanted to go all in with the G Flex 2 when we found that this was the first sighting in the wild of the Snapdragon 810. And as such, the 64-bit octa-core processor should be able to make everything fly beautifully, and we even did a benchmark test on the G Flex 2 that we were testing and found its scores to be among the best. Outside of the processor, the G Flex 2 packs a 3000 mAh battery and comes with either 16 or 32 gigabytes of onboard storage with a micro SD card slot, which is an addition here. And of course, one of LG's biggest features, aside from its flexing display, is the self-healing back. With superficial scratches, you should see an enhanced healing factor on here that allows for some superficial scratches to go away in under 10 seconds. Now, while that might be the case, even medium pressure using, let's say, this key that I used allowed it to maintain its scratches. Unfortunately, the removable back needed to be replaced. The camera is another great spot for the G Flex 2, as it features basically an enhanced version of the camera from the G3, which we thought was pretty great. The G Flex 2 features a 13 megapixel rear camera that gets OIS Plus, laser focus, and a dual flash. It is worth mentioning that the autofocus is said to be faster and offers a few minor camera software improvements as well, which we will be sure to take a closer look at in our in-depth review down the road. Self-portraits are, of course, a focus of this particular phone as the selfie revolution continues to gain steam, but in this case, using the hand gestures in order to take pictures has returned, but there is a nice new feature on here that I actually think is pretty great. The fact that you can take the G Flex 2, take a selfie, and then when you make the gesture by bringing the phone down in order to, let's say, hit the gallery icon and look at the picture that you just took, instead, the phone will detect that you want to and show the picture right away for a very quick self-preview. It's a pretty nice way of just making that particular procedure a little bit faster and a little bit easier. And finally, in software, for any of those who have had any experience with the LG G3, you really won't find many surprises here. Yes, the UI, or rather the operating system, has been upgraded to Android Lollipop, but a lot of the material design choices don't really make it here. You do get a bit of a different notification dropdown, though the setting shade does not pop out after you hit the top part. It is already expanded. And of course, you get the card version of the recent app screen. But from there, you really don't get all that many noticeable changes. One of the features that is of note here is the glance view, in which in the standby mode, you will be able to swipe downward at any point on the screen in order to just open up a small portion at the top to find little bits of information like the time and the date. But after that, you do have updates to things like the smart notice and the smart bulletin, where they will allow a little bit more information to be shown. But ultimately, a lot of what you see here is very similar to the most previous iterations of the LG UI. Availability and pricing for the G Flex 2 is still up in the air, at least when it comes to the West. We are sure that over the next couple months, we will be seeing this phone in South Korea, and then it will slowly go to other markets. But we are also certain that this phone, much like the original G Flex, is going to come in at a more premium price point than its flagship brethren like the G2 or the G3. And that will not be that surprising to us at all. And so there you have it, the LG G Flex 2, one of the biggest announcements at CES 2015 is certainly this particular phone that brings a unique design along with enhancements across the board that make it vastly better than the original G Flex, especially in terms of ergonomics, but brings a lot of what makes the LG G3 already a great flagship smartphone. Only they just curved it up a little bit. In the case of the G Flex 2, if you're looking for something that is unique but has all of the power of a flagship that LG can put out, well, you just might be finding the phone that you've been waiting for. Stay tuned to Android Authority for all of the best coverage of CES 2015. We are here on the show floor and getting to see a lot of great announcements and devices like this one right here. So stay tuned for my full review on this, the LG G Flex 2, in the near future. But until then, keep it tuned here for more coverage of CES 2015.